Hey, welcome to Farm Girl Fridays. I'm Mike, and I'm here today with a pumpkin pie recipe. In Canada, we celebrate Thanksgiving on the second Monday in October, so I know it's a lot earlier than those of you in the US, but I'm gonna make a pumpkin pie recipe. Hopefully, all of you in Canada will be able to use this recipe if you want a keto pumpkin pie using the Farm Girl low carb pastry mix. Okay, I'm gonna use that to make the crust, and then I've got a recipe for the filling that's pretty low carb as well. Pumpkin is actually keto friendly whenever you're eating it within moderation. For instance, 100 grams of broccoli, which people eat on keto all the time, has 6 grams of carbs in it, whereas 100 grams of pumpkin has 7 grams of carbs. So it's actually not that bad. And we're gonna use a keto sweetener, add in some cream, eggs, stuff like that, that is all on a keto diet. Okay, so I'm gonna start by making the crust. We'll let that sit for a little bit while I make the filling, roll out the crust, get this in the oven, and we'll have a pumpkin pie hopefully within about an hour, hour and 20 minutes total, with the bake time and everything included in that. You probably wanna do this in the afternoon on Thanksgiving or do it the day before. It sits really well overnight. But it's nice to have a pumpkin pie recipe that you can eat and enjoy when you're still following a keto diet, okay? So we'll start by making the crust. I'll bring us down to the bowl here. And I'm just gonna add into here. So I've got 1.5 cups, again, of the Farm Girl low carb pastry mix, okay? So we're gonna use this to make the crust today. I'm gonna add in 1/4 teaspoon of sea salt, okay? And I'll just mix this through. I like to use a pastry blender when I'm making a crust. If you don't have one of these pastry blenders, they kind of can look different. It's generally like the same design, but sometimes it's like thicker metal strips and stuff. You can do this with a fork if not, and you can also do it by hand. Okay, so what I'm gonna do into here is add, this is 1/2 cup. It looks like a lot, but it's actually just 1/2 cup of butter that's been diced up. So that is still a lot of butter, but it's what we need here. So you can do pie crust with butter and shortening, lard some people use. I like an all butter crust, personal preference. But so this is 1/2 cup of unsalted, good quality butter that I cut up into little cubes, and it was very cold. The thing with making a pie crust is you really want to make sure to keep the ingredients as cold as possible. So I've even in the past refrigerated the flour. This was actually in my back room, which is kind of cool anyway. I have ice water here for the next step. There's actually ice cubes. We want to keep everything really cold so the butter doesn't melt out into the pastry. Okay, so I'm going to go through here with my pastry blender and just press through. So we're looking to incorporate the butter into the flour, but not too much, okay? So what I wanna do, I'll just use the back of a knife to scrape this off every once in a while, just to keep the butter from sticking too much to the pastry blender. What we're looking for is like this, kind of like a coarse crumb, I've heard it described. You want the pieces of butter to be different sizes. So not big, huge chunks of butter, but you definitely don't wanna mix this to the point that the butter is really incorporated into the flour. So I know last week I did say I was going to be doing samosas, so stay tuned. Those are going to happen next week because Thanksgiving crept up on me here and I wanted to get something that was a little bit more relevant to Thanksgiving this weekend. So stay tuned for next week. There will be some awesome Indian samosas that are done with the Pizza Pro flour, making that the crust from that. But for today, so I'm just going to go over this for like another 10 seconds and I'll kind of bring it up closer in a second so you can see what I'm looking for. You've probably already made pastry crust many times, but this is really the trick, right? So the little chunks of butter, whenever you roll this out, those are what melt out and give you that really flaky laminated kind of look to a good pie crust. Okay, so this is looking pretty good. I'm just gonna go through and check. Yeah, this looks good because it'll get mixed a little bit more when we add in the liquid. Okay, so just bringing it up closer, you can see that there's still some little flecks of butter in there. Okay, some bigger flecks of butter, and it's not fully incorporated. Some big and small flecks. That's exactly what you're looking for when you're making a pie crust. Okay, so I'm gonna set aside the pastry blender. Now I'll grab a fork. And I'm gonna start with the lesser amount of water. So I put in here, I put into the recipe that you can start with like 3 or 4 tablespoons of water. I think I said 4 to 6, 3 to 5, 3 to 5. Okay, so I just wanna make sure. So I'm gonna start with 3 tablespoons of this really cold water. Okay, so adding that in, and then just going through with the fork lightly here. It's probably gonna take more than 3, but you wanna just be careful. If your flour, like I've said before, if your flour is kind of moist, if you've had it in a humid environment with the bag left open, stuff like that, it can take on a surprising amount of moisture, which means you need to add less water to some recipes, okay? So this is not enough, which I did suspect it was not gonna be enough. So I'll add 1 more tablespoon. You wanna go 1 at a time, don't go too fast, because it can get kind of sticky if you do too much. Okay, so I'm just gonna keep mixing this up. My flour has seemed to be kind of dry, so I'm gonna probably need this 5th tablespoon as well. I'll add the 1 more tablespoon here. It might still seem a little bit dry, and I'll show you in a second here. When you go through with your hands to form it, it will normally come together, okay? So yeah, this is looking good now. So you wanna just keep mixing to get all of those dry crumbs at the bottom up. What you're trying to avoid here is touching the pastry with your hands too much, because the warmth of your hands will start to melt that butter out, which is exactly what we're trying to avoid, right? Is keeping that, we want to keep that butter nice and cold. So in avoiding melting it out with the warmth of our hands as much as possible. Okay, so I'm just gonna go through and check this here. Now I'm gonna touch it. I'm just gonna kind of press it, kind of knead it just a little bit and see. Might still be a little bit dry. You just want to be careful, okay? No, and see, I think that sometimes like you'll get little pockets of water that are kind of hiding, right? Like aren't mixed through the flour very well. So yeah, as I knead this just a little bit, you don't want to knead it too much. We're trying to avoid any gluten being developed, okay? In a pie crust, you want it nice and tender. This feels really good, okay? So I'm going to now transfer this over to a piece of plastic wrap. Let's pull it some plastic wrap here. And I'll set my bowl aside. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna form this into a disc and I'll pop it in the fridge so that it can set up for a second. As about, you know, 15, 20 minutes, you can make the dough in advance. If you're doing that though, I would recommend that you let it warm up to room temperature a little bit before you try to roll it out. So if you like make this the day before and leave it in your fridge, it's really important that you don't try to roll it out from ice cold from the fridge, because it'll tend to crack quite a bit. Okay, so I'm just gonna go like that. We'll wrap this up. Bring in the edges. The plastic wrap is nice too, because you can really help to form it into this disc. If you get a nice disc, about an inch, like 2.5 centimeter stick, it makes it a lot easier later to roll it out into a circle for your pie plate, okay? So this is why we do this. Don't do it in like a big ball, because then it's really hard to roll out. So the disc is great. All right, still some little flecks of butter I can see in there. So I'm just going to pop this in the fridge and let that set up for about 15 minutes or so. Kind of allows the flours to absorb the moisture and hydrate properly. And then anything that you did warm up, that butter that you might have warmed up just by touching it now, it's gonna set back up in the fridge, okay? So, the pumpkin pie filling. If you're making keto pumpkin pie, you cannot buy pumpkin pie filling, okay? So it's can be very confusing at the store, because it can not always be that obvious the way things are labeled. What you're looking for is pure pumpkin puree, right? Pumpkin pie filling has already got the eggs and the dairy, the condensed milk and the sugar and all of that added in. Not keto friendly. It's gonna have tons of sugar in it. So when I actually went to the store, because it's Thanksgiving this weekend in Canada, finding pureed pumpkin was almost impossible. I went to two stores, couldn't find it. It was impossible for me to find it. I didn't want to go to a third store. I bought a pie pumpkin and I made my own. So you can do this yourself, right? My mom actually growing up always made our pumpkin pie with actual pumpkin. She never bought pumpkin puree in a can. She would roast pie pumpkins, peel them, seed them, roast them, and then puree them in the blender, which is what I did here. So I peeled one pie pumpkin. It gave me just over 2 cups. I ate a couple chunks of pumpkin because I just love the taste of pumpkin. But it was about 2 cups after I pureed it. So roasted in the oven at 375 for like an hour and 20 minutes, covered with just a splash of water. You can microwave it in a bowl with a splash of water, covered in plastic wrap or covered with a plate. There's lots of different ways. You can Google that to get your pumpkin puree, okay? Or one 15-ounce can. It's just a little under 2 cups, will also work perfectly fine. So the recipe calls for 2 cups or one 15-ounce can, okay? So I'm gonna grab a bowl. I'll bring us back down here. I just wanna talk about the pumpkin for a second. If you've never made it from scratch, you can try that. It's really not that much more work. The first thing I'm gonna add into the bowl is the eggs, just so I can beat them a little bit first. I wanna make sure that the eggs are broken up nicely before I try to add these other ingredients into here. Okay, so just a quick whisk to break up those yolks and whites. It's ideal to have everything at room temperature. You don't want everything ice cold, because it can tend to make the crust might burn before everything cooks through. When you put an ice cold filling into the oven, it takes a lot longer for it to come up to the temperature where it's gonna set, right? So after this, after the eggs are in here, we can really add everything else in all at once. So I've got my 2 cups of pureed pumpkin. Okay, and different kinds of pumpkin will have different colors. Some brands, when you buy the canned stuff, are like bright orange. I've actually seen some brands, if they don't say 100% pumpkin on them, they can actually have some squash or some sweet potato and stuff added into them. I actually have seen that with one brand before to give it better color, which is totally fine. I've actually made this with butternut squash before and it tastes great. You can make it with sweet potato puree as well. It'll taste great. 1/2 cup of whipping cream. If you're trying to avoid dairy, you can do this with coconut milk as well. Okay, we'll add a little bit of coconutty flavor to the pumpkin pie, but it's gonna taste good. I'm gonna add in 1/2 cup of sweetener. Okay, so this is like the like a erythritol brown sugar blend, right? So you can do any sweetener you like. That's keto friendly. Okay, I've got. So I put in the recipe 2 to 3 teaspoons of pumpkin spice. I love pumpkin spice. Okay, so I do 3 teaspoons in mine. That might be too much for some people. Your call. Okay, I make my own pumpkin spice. You can buy it pre-made, or you can look up a recipe online for your own blend. Okay, this is 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, and then 1/4 teaspoon of sea salt. Okay, the salt's important to help lift the flavors. So what I'm gonna do now is just whisk this all up until everything is uniform. This is really all there is to it. Now, pumpkin pie spice does deepen the color of it. That's what gives it more of that kind of burnt orange color that pumpkin pie has. Comes from the pumpkin pie spice. Okay, and those eggs are gonna be a big part of what sets this up. Okay, so that's really it. I'm just gonna finish whisking that for another second or so here. Make sure everything's uniform. You can check the bottom if you got a glass bowl. Looks good. Nothing kind of hiding at the bottom there. And I'll let this sit for a minute. I'll whisk it again before I add it to the pie crust. What you don't want to do is whisk it way too much. You'll get a ton of bubbles in there. So you don't need to like beat it or anything like that. We're just whisking to incorporate all the ingredients together. And after it sits for a few minutes, I'll whisk one more time in case some of the sugar was not dissolved. It'll be dissolved after sitting for a minute. We can whisk it up. Okay, so I'm just gonna give another 10 minutes for that pie crust. So I'll cut here and come back. I'll show you how to roll it the pie crust, make a fancy edge on it. We'll get this in the oven and then we will finish the pumpkin pie. Okay, so I'll be right back. Okay, so I've got the dough. It's been sitting in the fridge. It was about 15 or 20 minutes, but almost 20 minutes that I had it chilling in the fridge. Just firms up a little bit and it starts, again, that moisture kind of gets reabsorbed into the flour. So what I'm gonna do is unwrap it. I like to roll my pastry out on a piece of parchment paper. You can also like flour a surface and do that, even like under the parchment paper, underneath it on the parchment paper, a little bit of the pastry mix is good. This makes it a lot easier to transfer it onto the pie plate whenever you do it on the parchment like this. Okay, so a little bit underneath, a little bit on top, not too much, just a bit to help keep it from sticking to the rolling pin. Okay, so now I'm gonna just roll it out. We're looking for about 2.5 centimeters, sorry, about 5 centimeters or 2 inches bigger than the pie plate that we're trying to put it into, okay? So I've got a 9-inch, just a standard 9-inch pie plate here. That's kind of the standard size. If you're doing a deep dish pie, you would need more filling and more crust, okay? And we're just gonna roll this out, keep rotating it to try to get a nice uniform circle. This piece of parchment paper is just the right width, I know, so I want a circle that's about that wide for this pie plate. Okay, it doesn't have to be a perfect circle, but we want to try to keep it as uniform as possible. Keep rotating it, you'll end up with something pretty round. And the edges don't have to be perfect, so don't stress about that. Okay, so now I'm about that width of this piece of parchment, which again, like I said, I know is the right width for this pie plate. Okay, so I'm just gonna stop there. I can just double check with my pie plate. You can see that it's just about 2 inches around, most of the way around. So I just can see that over here needs a little bit more. So I'll try to get a little bit more length there. Okay, and that should work. Just like that. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now, this is why I find this a bit easier. If I just move the pie crust away, take the plate here, kind of hold onto it with your thumbs. You can't see, I'm gonna hold onto it with my thumbs as I pick it up and transfer it, just flip it over. Okay, so then the parchment will make your life a lot easier trying to get it into your pie plate. Okay, so from there, I'm just gonna gently kind of guide it in. Okay, get it into the corners. And what I like to do here is I like scissors. You can use a knife here and go around with a knife. I prefer a pair of scissors. And just to go around and clip it, I wanna clip it a little bit bigger than the lip of the pie plate. I'll show you why in a second here. And these scraps don't have to go in the garbage. I can show you what we can do with those after. so we can make some little cutouts to put on top of the pie after. Okay, so I'm just going around, I'm feeling, making it a little bit, maybe a centimeter or so bigger than the lip of the pie plate. Like I said, you can do this with a knife. Just find a little bit easier with a pair of kitchen scissors. Okay, so like that, pretty uniform. Separate, set that aside. And then what I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna go around and I'm gonna tuck underneath the edge, fold it onto itself, just tuck it under a little bit like that. There's so many different ways you can finish the edge of a pie. I always do it, I've done it always pretty much the same way. So I'm just gonna make this little edge. Don't have to make it perfect right now. If it cracks a little bit, that's okay. Okay, so just folding it underneath. It's nice to have a little bit thicker. Oh, there's a doubled up piece there. It's nice to have it a little bit thicker on the edge, right? So that, first of all, so it doesn't cook too quickly, because it can tend to burn a little bit if the edge is too thin. Okay, so now that I have this, I'm gonna go through, I'm just gonna kind of press it with my fingers, trying to not touch it too much. So again, I'm not melting out any of that butter in there too much, but just like this, kind of anywhere that it cracked, you can kind of form it back together. Pie crust is pretty forgiving. Okay, and then what I like to do is a crimped edge. So you're gonna take, pinch two fingers like this, and then with your other one finger, you're gonna go around, see, like this. Like this is what we're gonna do. So I'm gonna go from the two fingers on the inside, the single finger on the outside, and you just keep going around, and you will end up with a nice crimped edge on your pie, okay? So this is the way I do it. You can, if again, if it cracks a little bit, you can go back after and kind of even that out. It's not the end of the world. Depends on how perfect you want it to be. You can go around with a fork and just press it with a fork. There's lots of different, if you go online, there's like insane, crazy, beautiful ways that you can do the edge of a pie. Okay, and then once you've got that done, you can just kind of go back through anywhere that doesn't look perfect. You can press it down a little bit. If the edges are kind of cracking on the top anywhere, you can kind of press it down to even that out. Okay, and if you do that and you lose some of the crimp, just go back and crimp it again. Okay, and that's essentially what we're looking for. So this is good to go. We don't need to pre-bake this pie crust for this filling because it's gonna be in the oven for quite a while, okay? So just making sure it's down in all the corners, just like that. And then I'm going to add in my filling. Oh, so I'm just gonna mix it one more time, like I said earlier. So just not whisking it too heavily because a lot of the bubbles have come out of it already. So I'm just gonna whisk one more time gently to make sure any sugar that kind of settled and wasn't dissolved is going to dissolve now. And that spatula has helped me to get it out of the bowl. Okay, so this should be the right amount for a standard 9-inch pie crust. Like that. Okay, now I've got my oven preheated to 425 Fahrenheit. That's like 220 Celsius. I start in a hot oven and then I lower the temperature after about 10 minutes is the way that I like to do a pumpkin pie. There's lots of different ways you can do it. You can do it just lower for the whole time. And I'm just gonna get this in here, shake it a little bit to level it out. What I have not done is I don't wanna put a tray underneath this. So what I've done is put the oven rack to the bottom third. It doesn't have to be the lowest one, but like one up from the bottom. And that will help to ensure that the top doesn't burn burn fast, and that the bottom of the crust is actually gonna be browned through, okay? So I'm gonna pop this in my oven at 425 for 10 minutes, and then I will lower the temperature down to 350 and do it for about another 30 to 45 minutes. It'll depend on your oven, how thick, you know, how thick the edges of your crust, all of that kind of stuff. I'll show you what we're looking for. Basically, the way to test this as you're going is to stick a knife, like just a paring knife like this, 1 inch, so I'll show you here, and I can show you again after, but just so you know. So 1 inch in from the edge of the crust, you stick in the tip of the knife. If it comes out clean, then it's done. The center will still be a little bit jiggly, and it will finish setting as it cools down, but that's kind of the way to test it. But I'll bring it out when it's done, and I will show you. I'm gonna pop this in the oven, and I will be back in like an hour once the pie's done, okay? Okay, so that was about 45 minutes. It took a little longer than I expected to get it cooked all the way through. Some of my ingredients might not have been right at room temperature, but I'll just show you here. Actually, I'll put the glove back on. So the center is still gonna look a little tiny bit wet. It's just got a little jiggle left to it, but it'll finish setting up as it cools. You're gonna try inserting, again, the knife in about an inch in from the edge of the pie crust, and you pull it in and out should come out pretty much clean, okay? So what I'm gonna do here, I have my little cutouts that I baked when I lowered the oven temperature down. It took about 10 minutes. You can just place these around on top. Now that it's finished setting, they should, well, they won't sink inside, okay? So you can go like this, do something like that. And you want to let this cool completely before you attempt to cut into it, okay? It's really important not to try to cut it while it's still hot, because it will just end up falling or oozing everywhere, okay? But there you go. Beautiful pumpkin pie, keto friendly. Next Friday, I'll be doing Indian samosas for Farm Girl Friday, so join me at 12 p.m. Eastern Time. Please hit the thumbs up, like the video, comment on it, share this into social media. Really helps the channel grow. We really appreciate the support, okay? Farm Girl, pastry mix, pie crust, and pumpkin pie keto filling. So enjoy your Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving to all my Canadian friends out there, and happy early Thanksgiving to all the Americans out there. Maybe I'll bring something in for Thanksgiving whenever it's time in America, okay? Have an awesome day. I'll see you soon.